Students, welcome back. In 1791, France became a constitutional monarch. The new constitution was made, a new government was made, in which the government was divided between three organs, executive, legislature and judiciary. But unfortunately, this government was not right because the voting right was only given to the active members and not the passive members. Remember? So this again made the society unrest. And at last, when people found that this government was not up to the mark, then in the next topic we learned that how France abolishes monarchy and became a republic. In this particular scenario, we have to explain the role of Jacobean government. I hope you people know the role of the Jacobean government in abolishing monarchy from France. The Jacobean people were led by their leader Maximilien Robespierre, who was basically belonged to a common people group, and this government was mainly supported universal adult franchise and equality among all, eradication of privileges, etc. And at last, in 1792, Jacobins came to the power, and on 21st September 1792, France abolishes monarchy and became a republic. This is what we have learned in the third topic. But in this topic, one thing more we have learned, that in the initial stages, Jacobin government was very nice. Do you remember that? He made several changes. I think you people remember. And all those changes are very good. Like he abolishes titles, and lord and lady, and he gave citoyen and citoyenne, the title used by the men and women of France, to bring equality in the society. Moreover, he also introduced standardized weight and measure for a uniform development of trade and commerce in the country. He also abolishes white bread and ordered all the people to use brown bread, so that there must be an equality, because white bread was used by the rich people. So in order to bring equality in the society, he told the people to use brown bread. In this way, he made several good things. Okay, but after doing all these things, slowly Maximilien Robespierre started behaving like a dictator king, and he slowly he started doing several illegal things also. So from the period 1793 to 1794, it was called as the Reign of Terror. I hope you people remember. And at last, Maximilien Robespierre was also eradicated. He was guillotined. And after him, there was a direct rule in France, which was the most unstable rule, because it was ruled by five directors from the different corners of the society, who never came to one point, and as a result there was always unrest and disturbance in the society. Okay, now after this point, we have learned one most important point: women and revolution. What was the role of the woman in the revolution? Women participated in the French Revolution because they want several rights and ease from the government, but they were not given any rights even after the revolution. Okay, but it was during the Jacobin government, I told you, I think you people remember, that women got several rights, like they got the right of starting their own business, getting education, to get married according to their choice, to divorce. All these things were given to women, but they were not given the most important right, and that was right to vote. So this is what we have learned in Women and Revolution. Then in the next topic, we have learned about the abolition of slavery. Slavery was there even after the revolution. I told you, the French Revolution stands for equality and fraternity, but still, after the revolution, slavery was continued. But it was during the Jacobin government when finally slavery was abolished. But in directory government, it was reintroduced, and Napoleon, when came to the power, he fully introduced slavery with great, speed. Then we have learned about revolution and everyday life. In this, we have learned how the people and the life of the everyday people were highly influenced by the revolution. And at last, we have learned about the conclusion in which we have learned the rise of Napoleon. Student, this was just a, you know, full scenario. I know I have given the, full lesson in this very limited time, but this was for your recalling the full chapter so that it will help you in, in your preparation. Okay. So I will give you the notes, which is followed by this, lecture. There will be a PDF file. You find the notes. Okay. So get ready for the second chapter in the next day, and best of luck for your exam and your preparation. Thank you very much. That's all for today.